I could hold up my end if your people weren't sabotaging my operations.
Hi. Well, greetings.
And if sabotaging the orchards weren't enough, you had to make it personal. You really had to bust my instant coffee maker, too? The nerve.
Hold that asinine thought. Who is this armed stranger who just wandered into your office? Back up for a fight you can't finish?
What the hell are you talking about? I don't know this lass. Huh. I think it's mightily more likely that she's under your payroll. You'd have burned down what you haven't already.
I'm not under anyone's payroll, which is not to say I can't be.
I see. Just a visitor, then. Congratulations, Hathaway. Not everyone's abandoned your orchards.
Well, shame that you're trying to change that. Anyway, sorry for the heated reception, stranger. There's just been some trouble here of late.
No kidding.
Name's Overseeing Orchardist Hathaway, and I'm in charge of these orchards. Though it seems like certain groups, which will remain unnamed, are trying to change that. Looks like I'm stuck playing the part of customer service rep. Guess it's different from the usual, at least. Something I can do for you?
I overheard you mention sabotage?
Yeah. Just another woe to add to the pile. In the past, the orchard subcontracted security work from Slug. You know, keep the malcontents on staff from causing too much trouble. But between the Spectrum Brown unveiling demanding all of our resources and the recent uptick in worker accidents, we just ain't got the budget for security. And, of course, Slug has decided that instead of being reasonable, they're just gonna sabotage our operations until we start paying them again.
Look at the poor Rizzo's manager. Lying about sublight to make himself feel better. Shame he skipped where Rizzo's were short on our payments months before the new unveiling.
Look, at the end of the day, it's obvious that Slug is sabotaging us. I ain't paying until they come clean.
What sort of sabotage has there been?
Oh, you know, nothing particularly troublesome. Just rogue exterminator mechanicals, opening fire on anything that twitches within 300 yards of them. We've also got a large group of new saplings, all dead from some kind of toxic substance. Poison, I guess. And who could forget the tower processing console, which probably just shorted out and stopped working on its own, even though it's outfitted with 3 separate backup systems?
There are a suite of explanations for what could have happened, most pointing to Rizzo's worker incompetence. My people didn't sabotage anything.
Okay, you also mentioned an increase in worker accidents?
It's the strangest thing. Like, everyone forgot their 10-minute workplace safety seminars. That's twice as long as the next leading brand. Our people should be safety experts.
10 minutes?
I've seen folks step on open electrical wires, drop pallets on each other. One damn fool even blundered into a wasp keto hive.
Wasp keto?
As he died, he looked fairly pleased.
Wasp keto. Cross between a wasp and a mosquito. Oof, I'm gonna have nightmares tonight. I could figure out what's really going on.
Thank the law, some good news. You hear that, lapdog? Truth's coming. Better fess up while you still can outside of an interrogation room.
While I'm sure you'd love to have a scapegoat on whom you can pin your own incompetence, I suspect you'll be disappointed. But what do I know? I suppose it's up to your new hiree.
Faithful to the Rizzos in our fashion. Huh.
You're back, I see. Glad Slug hasn't managed to scare you off.
I think it's more of a wonder that nothing in these law-forsaken orchards has managed to kill them.
How's the investigation going? You got a complete report for me yet?
I haven't gone in the orchard yet. I'm still looking.
Well, at the moment I can't do a whole lot with this vulture hanging over my shoulder. So I suppose you may as well take your time.
Really now? I consider myself more of a watch canid, here to make sure you don't try to run off without paying us.
There's something else you need to know?
Yeah. Any leads on the nursery?
Got a lot of dead saplings that'll cost us a lot of bits. I've got a feeling someone poisoned them somehow.
What happened in the Exterminator Auto Mech Depot?
The mechanicals were hacked. They're pretty much running amok. If you could keep from destroying too many, I'd be obliged. Would save us a lot. That said, you might want to be careful. Those things are built to take on Waspkitos, and Waspkitos are generally tougher to kill than people. Just something to keep in mind.
I'm afraid I'm going to destroy all of them. Something in particular to look out for in the processing control room?
The tower processing console is completely fried. Whoever took it out must have used some kind of explosive.
Okay. What do you have to say for yourself?
I'm sorry you had to come in on such a brusque conversation. Not everyone appreciates the work Slug does on Eridanos.
Especially not folk that Slug is trying to extort.
Alright, it seems I need to say it yet again. We're not stomping upon your purple berries or knocking your workers off the planetoid. All we want is for you to pay your dues.
And I want you to stop setting our exterminator mechanicals loose and breaking our machinery.
This is how the conversation has gone for the last hour and a half. As you can see, it hasn't been terribly productive.
What seems to be your problem with the overseeing orchardist?
Well, he's being difficult, as you've no doubt seen. All I'm here to do is enforce an agreed-upon business relationship. But our friend here is disinclined to settle.
Don't tell me to settle! Why don't you settle?
Yes, I'll be sure to do that. I know what you must be thinking, but no, I'm not here to atomize his kneecaps. I just want Slug to get what we're owed.
Is this an official arrangement with Rizzo's?
Much as we love giving the bureaucrats 29% of our profits, technically not. Official contracts have some rather obscene fees and documentation. Instead, our company's opted for a non-official manager's agreement. I'm just here to make certain our friend over there pays on time.
He probably owes a lot of money, so I'm not thinking about paying them. So are you sure? You sound a bit like an extortionist.
Do I? Didn't realize that expecting my company to be paid for its work was extortion. You should try telling that to the board. Regardless, Slug's Protection Service has ensured that Rizzo's has had zero problems with its shipments at the docks. And all for a reasonable price. We haven't been hostile when their payments came up short either. In fact, Rizzo's is more of a danger to the orchards than us, considering all the workplace injuries.
Likely story. Any truth to his accusations of sabotage?
If I hear that question one more time, I swear. Look, we just want to get paid. Hampering our clients' productivity is not a good way to get paid. In fact, it's bad business. Yes, I think we've spoken enough about that imbecile. What can Slug do for you?
I'd like to ask a little more about you.
You're welcome to. I don't have any secrets.
Do you do anything other than make sure Slug's business partners pay on time?
Certainly. When I'm not out on a job, they usually stick me in the Slug mess hall. I may be a service collector, but that doesn't mean I can't make a damn fine trip of kale pie.
Okay, you see any sign of Halcyon Helen recently?
Nope. Sorry, but this is the first I've visited this area in over a month. Shame about Helen. Liked her movies.
They were a much-needed diversion from the inadequacies of life in Halcyon.
Celebs as big as Helen always seem to elicit strong binary opinions in people. But that's neither here nor there.
Alright, thanks. Sheepy time.
Easy does it.
I'll just show myself out. Alright, what's this structure here? Oh, we got stuff here.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
More footprints.
These footprints match the shoes previously analyzed in the Grand Ballroom. There is a 110% chance with a 10% margin of error that they were left by Ruth Bellamy, the actress known as Halcyon Helen.
Yeah, it took me a few episodes to realize that Halcyon Helen is the character name and Ruth Bellamy is the actress's actual name. They seem to call her, you know, whatever they feel like. Examine the footprint depth and spacing. The spacing between each footstep is short and the imprint in the dirt deep, as if determined. It would appear that Helen was in a hurry. Really?
Have you found something, Captain?
It's just salt tuna for breakfast. There are definitely Helen's footprints.
One step closer to the truth. Get it? Because it's a footprint?
Yeah.
I'll just let you concentrate.
Thanks. Effusive host? Alright, whoops. Let's just, check out this over here. Let's see if there's anything tucked back in here. Hello? Biped. Oh! Drunk hunter? Time to sober up! Ooh! Always gonna come up. Oops. Wait. I wanted to reload. Drunk primal hide. The still bloody rawhide of an intoxicated primal. This would make a nice blanket for someone 3 sheets to the wind. Drunk primal brain. The wrinkly brain of an inebriated primal. There's no need to add fixative to this brain to keep it from decaying. It's already pre-pickled. Gotta love these descriptions. And that's the stuff they were getting high on, or drunk on. Caution! Pollinization swarms in use in this area. Unauthorized personnel may be killed at their own expense. How do you get killed on someone else's expense? That would be a good trick, right? A dead person. Oh, I can't unlock that one? It requires 150? I forget. How do you use these mag picks? I have mag picks, right? Stealing is not the answer. Stealing is the question. The answer is yes. It's been so long since I played this guy that I think just having your inventory works. Okay, so we're not getting in that one. Another effusive host. Maybe he should have been wearing that armor. Nothing on top of these. Oh, I'm way down again? Man, that happens quickly. Oh, is there like actually no way in here? Oh yeah, I have all this stuff. Hunting rifle hyper. Shotguns. The Vermin 2. Grenade Launcher 2. I like the flamethrower. It goes to, I'm not gonna say rounds. Ammunition, I guess? Very quickly. What's 17? It's a heavy machine gun, 109, revolver, assault rifle ultra 1032. The music wore out. I should be good for a while now. So this actual... no actual way in here. Just making sure there's no way in here. Okay then. What's this thing? Another flamethrower. I keep finding more. I'm not looking forward to coming across these mosquito wasp things. They're getting drunk on the purple berry stuff, of course. That's what's around here. Where were the others? Oh wait, nope, that's a rock? Alright, let's check out this area then. I don't see them. I'm just missing some trunk hides and purple berry crunch. Oh, hello?
Administrator Ludovico can seem intimidating, but he's a decent fellow. I know he cares.
Okay. These people are a little freaky.
Wow.
Yeah, wow. To know. The Dissident Queen, Chapter 2. I read this. think I did. Mr. N. What's Mr. N? I don't know what Mr. N is. That one's not a steal. What about these things? Well, these are free to take. Okay. Maybe not do it that way.
Nicely done.
I heard someone like coughing. All right. Oh. Hello?
Mm-hmm. Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Incoming!
What?
I can't hear you laughing!
What?
No, I just wanted to make you smile!
Real funny!
That one's done for!
They were creepy. Holy crap. So these are enemies. Effusive hosts. That's a frenzied host. Where's the other one? This isn't the one we killed, right?
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby. Congratulations, Inspector. You've discovered more footprints belonging to the deceased actress known as Halcyon Helen.
Hmm. Okie dokie. Oh, right here.
Congratulations, Inspector. You've discovered more footprints belonging to the deceased actress known as Halcyon Helen.
Yep. Congratulations. to me. Alright, so over here we got some hedges and another audio thing.
Rizzo's would be remiss to fail to mention the Orchard Storage Warehouse. Without this impressive looking building, there would simply be no orchards. Gaze in amazement at the impressive construction of the front door, the sleek roof and glittering piping, the lush walls keeping this gem hidden from the rest of the orchards. This warehouse is truly, truly a wonder. One can only guess at the secrets contained within.
We don't have to guess. Nursery storage. Anna Summers.
Hey! Oh, wait. I'm supposed to say this, Logan.
Nah.
You can do this, Anna.
No, skip it.
Here goes.
We don't need it. No.
It doesn't matter if you're you or me. We're all part of the Rizzo's family. How was that?
I thought that was a real good effort. Keep at it.
I don't think that was a Rizzo slogan or any company slogan for that matter. If you're trying to arm family, instead of family, you should go family. It would rhyme better. But yeah, I don't think that was a Rizzo slogan.
Ouch. Well, your candor's appreciated. Even if it means I'll have to hit the books even harder tonight. I'm sure you've guessed it, but I'm not the best at remembering slogans. And when I can't remember them, I tend to just make them up. But I guess that's why I'm just an intern and not a full-timer. At least, not yet.
You haven't been causing any trouble here in the orchards, have you?
What? No, that's ridiculous. I can't tell you I've never made any mistakes, but it'd be pretty hard to keep my job if I were trying to break everything. Though there was the time I tried to fix a broken hinge on one of our mosquito hives and released a swarm. Chased me around the orchards 3 times before I managed to get help.
You were chased by wasp mosquitoes? What's the deal with those?
Well, they're really mean, for one thing. Mosquitoes don't stop stinging you when you die. They keep going for 10 or 15 minutes after. Don't worry, though. Mosquitoes are typically only about when living folks aren't in the orchards.
Yeah, I have a feeling we'll be coming across them, though. So what happens if the wasp mosquitoes get out during visiting hours?
I am contractually obligated to tell you that mosquitoes never get out during visiting hours. But when they do, the only way to get them to return is to go directly to hive control and activate emergency recall. Which isn't easy, considering all the hives near control. But this is all a departure from what I wanted to say. I've been trying to help the orchards, not harm them. Hold a moment. You haven't found anything, have you?
You should really just come clean?
But there's nothing to come clean about. I've just been doing my best out here.
Right. Well, I don't think I've ever met an intern before.
It's not so different from being a regular worker. Just with less pay and less respect. Oh, it's also more dangerous than traditional employment. You don't have the experience to back up your work yet, but being fired isn't any less threatening. Work-wise, I do a bit of everything. The orchards have been short-staffed as long as I've been working here. So if there's an odd job around, it usually gets passed to me.
Why be an intern if it's riskier than typical employment?
Much higher chance of promotion. If I can tough it out here without getting axed, I can skip the 5+ years of customer service I'd normally have to deal with. I can prove my merit here and move up in the world. And the sooner I do that, the sooner I can set to improving things for everyone else.
Helping folks is dangerous. The board doesn't like people who mess with the status quo.
Mother did mention that from time to time, but she always kept me far away from her work. Who could complain about happier workers and higher profit gains?
So, from what you say, I take it you don't intend to stay an intern, and you want to get promoted in 5 years, or save 5 years from being cut off 5 years before you're promoted, basically.
Much as I love delivering coffee and medical attention, not quite, no. Don't tell anyone I said this, but I sometimes feel that our workers could be treated a little better. Maybe only get electrocuted awake every other day? So I'm shooting for administration in Rizzo's.
Maybe even the board itself. Best way to evoke change is from the inside, I think.
How did you get your position?
Laws, you've got a sixth sense for finding the most embarrassing question, huh?
Huh.
My mother is the Rizzo's assistant vice president of flavor testing. She set me up with this position. Mostly to keep me from troubling her work, I think. Consequently, I don't always feel like I deserve to be here. All the more reason to work harder, I say.
Alright. I think I've learned my fill.
Happy to enlighten you on the fascinating world of internships. Let me know if there's anything I can help you with. Unless you already have, and I've forgotten. In which case, I probably won't forget a second time.
You sure do talk a lot. You see any sign of a beleaguered actor running around?
Oh yes. I thought I saw someone who looked self-important enough to be her by the conservatory some time ago. Not to speak ill of the dead. I simply never liked the way she stole the limelight from the true star. Burbage 3001.
You're a Burbage fan?
I certainly am. That aerodynamic chassis, how the light glints off his rotund head, the way he enunciates, cry havoc, and let loose the cadence of war. Excuse me, I got a little lightheaded there. Nobody does Shakespeare like Burbage. What were we talking about?
Oh, done talking about that. Are you... what about Spencer Woolrich?
Who?
Alright.
I suppose so. I also suppose Helen won't be stealing the limelight ever again.
Stealing the limelight? Yeah, maybe not in full sight of somebody.
I'll keep quiet.
Haha. None the wiser. Thing. Welcome to the Purpleberry Orchard Storage Building, the sweetest storage building this side of Eridanos. Note, please do not attempt to lick any part of the storage building. Most components contain at least 40% cyanide. Why would you lick it? Access inventory records. Current inventory. Item, Gardner Automechanical. Amount, 23 or so. Status, beat up. Notes, wasp skeetos. Wasp ketos. It keeps. There should be wasp skeetos, not wasp ketos. Keep stinging these, breaking their stingers, and dying. Should probably keep them separate. Mock apples and purple berries. Amount. A heck of a lot. Status. Hard to count. Notes. Do we really gotta number every single fruit? We've got more than enough. Item. Wasp ketos. Amount. Couple hundred hives. Status. Real grumpy. Notes. Don't get stung by these. Item. Spectrum vodka. All colors. Amount. One left. Status. One shipment to the puzzle hedges. One to the nut hut. Notes. Swing by the nut hut with some of my savings later today. It's been a long week. View groundskeeper note. The purple berries are growing. The orchard's... sowing and reaping facility. The purple berries are growing a heck of a lot faster than the automechanicals can pick them. I should be mighty perturbed by what we're wasting since I had that treatment, all I felt is glad about things. Goodness, this promotion sure was a life changer. Speaking of, Rudy, I have a feeling you're reading this. Caught you a couple times peering at me from behind hedges and the like. How about you swing by my shack and we bury the hatchet? I'm a changed man since you recommended me for this promotion. Got a bottle of Spectrum Vodka we can share and a chapter of the brand new Halcyon Helen cereal. Knew you never liked that I got advanced copies. Come on by, Jacob. View Overseeing Orchardist. Note. Yarbo? I must admit that when your old superior described you as a misanthropic, law-damned... redacted. I did not expect you would ever acclimate to a position so many others have loathed. Productivity is at an all-time high, and what's more, you've not only impressed many visitors with your wonderful attitude, but you somehow seem to get along well with the wasp ketos. Or at least they haven't killed you yet. I would like to offer you an unprecedented reward, a one-time minute, 15-minute break, to be taken at your discretion. Well done, Yorbo. Well done, Yorbo. Overseeing Orchardist Hathaway. A one-time 15-minute... Oh, God. To J. Yarbo, subject hypotheticals. From H. Carlos. So, Jacob, got a quick rhetorical question for you. Let's say rhetorically that one of the Wilderness Exploitation Reserve keepers got drunk and thought he'd indulge himself in some after-hours hunting. Let's say he theoretically released our primals, and those primals theoretically proceeded to beat him to death with his own rifle, then escaped to the orchards. Obviously, I'm just worrying for the sake of worrying, but if something like that were to happen, I'm not saying it did, especially since such a screw-up could cost me my job, theoretically, Rizzos may have tested some of their products on these primals, and these primals may have acquired a taste for Rizzo's booze, booze that I know you have stocked in the orchards. Look, if you see any wayward primals, and I'm not saying you will, please, for the love of the law, send me a message. Huntmaster Carlos. Anything behind back of the building here? Dead person. Alright, I'm gonna call it an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one, and always, seek an adventure. Seek an adventure. Seek adventure!